Okay. Hallelujah. So we continue. The devil is a liar, and so is the phone when it's not obeying. But all things work together for our good, and it's going to work out well. Praise God. You know, there are some things that I learned. There are some... I love to sing in the presence of God. And one time I was singing, I was having a good time just singing praises to God. I love singing praises to God. I was on my guitar. And then I had gone into it like over an hour. And then I saw an angel appear. And he had a chitenge and he was dancing. And I freaked out for a moment. I was like, oh my goodness, what's this? It looked a bit funny. But eventually I came to learn there are some songs which when you start singing, you can't stop because the presence of God descends on them. The presence of God descends on them. So when you start singing the song, you can't stop. And this is why there are some songs, you sing them over and over and over and they're just not getting out of fashion because they've got a presence. And they influence people's lives. And they channel the anointing of the Spirit a certain way. Sad to say, but even the opposite is true. There are some songs which are sung in the presence of an evil spirit. Just this morning, I had an encounter. I'm sure I'll be able to share it after this short praise session where God was showing me some of this stuff. So there are some songs which I'll sing over and over again, and I'll just not get over them.
Excellent, yeah.
Charm, you know, with an ara, charm, you know, they can pack him in a pocket. Oh boy, their God is so small. And then for some, they can carve their God, you know, they can panga him and even create him after their own image and likeness and give him a name. I mean, all manner of strangeness out there in the world. But our God is very big. It's very big. You cannot even imagine. The Bible says the earth is his footstool. You can just imagine. It's interesting. The earth is God's footstool. That means that's why he puts his feet and sits in his throne. He's that big. Yet, he can be so small that he can live in your heart. One time I had an experience where, you know, I was praying. I was asking the Lord for something. And boom, the Lord appeared. I must have been in third year at the University of Zambia, you know, back in the day. The Lord appeared to me in a vision. And one remarkable thing I saw in that vision was I saw the whole lot of the world in the eyes of the Lord, the eyes of the Lord Jesus. They are so beautiful when you look into his eyes. But the whole lot of the world fitted into his eyes. I don't know how I can explain it. It shouldn't even make sense anyways. But it was not like in pictorial form, you know, that thing where it's reflecting. No, but like the whole world was within him. Oh boy. I hope you understand one of these days. So God is that big. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody said glory. Type glory to God. Shadabaya man. Tagadiya man. We're going to have a good time in the next few minutes, in which I'm going to share the word of God with you. We have been talking about the fruit of the Spirit. And when we began talking about fruit of the Spirit, I think we ended on the book of John chapter 8. Yes, and in the book of John chapter 8, the Lord Jesus Christ engages the Pharisees in a conversation. Or they engage in. Either way, there was an engagement. Hallelujah. And they begin discussing. And as they are discussing, Jesus uses some tough language. But there's some things that he said that are very important that I would love us to have a short recap on. The Bible indicates to us that Jesus Christ used language like, you don't understand my language. And I remember I explained that it is not language in terms of tribe. Okay? You get my point, right? Somebody type, yes, Pastor, I get your point. It is not language in terms of tribe. The language we speak, maybe it's not like Jesus was speaking Greek and then they couldn't understand because they were from Silanga or something. It's the thought code. He was unable to get to them. They couldn't speak the same language. They couldn't have the same kind of understanding. They couldn't sit down. It's like, imagine somebody's a doctor and there's some surgery and procedures that are supposed to be done on a person. And then you, who's, let's say, specialized in photocopying and binding, you know, you go to the doctor and you sit down and they start listening to them, then they start explaining to you. They may be using English, but you don't hear a thing. Why? Because You've got two different languages. You are speaking two different languages. The doctor is speaking a different language. So it's about the thought court. Okay? So Jesus Christ is talking to these guys and he's telling them, look, you cannot understand me. You don't understand the language I speak to you. That's John chapter number 8. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. God is good. John chapter number 8. And I'm going to read from verse 42. Jesus said to them, if God were your father, you'd love me, for I proceed forth and came from God. Nor have I come myself, but he sent me. Why do you not understand my language? See? He says, why don't you understand my language? Let's just imagine they were both speaking English, but he says, you don't understand my language. Then he says, because you are not able to listen to my word. Okay? You are of your father the devil. Can imagine this one, even his disciples wanted to say, Jesus, the Pharisees, don't crucify him. No, Peter would do that. And so he says, you are of your father the devil. And everybody goes, whoa. The disasters of your father you want to do. He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. This is also language. Truth is a language. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. It's a language. Truth is a language. The same way deceit is a language. Now, the Bible says Satan has been a murderer from the beginning and there's no truth in him. And then interestingly, he says when he speaks a lie, he speaks his native language. You understand that? So it's not about tribe. It's thought court. Satan has got no capacity to tell the truth. He can't tell the truth. The same way you wouldn't want your phone to start eating. Think about what you want. I know people have got make friends with everything these days, and you know they give human beings they give pets human names and all that kind of stuff. You find the cat is called Garfield or something, you know. So they come so close, but there are certain things you don't expect it to do because it's an animal. You don't expect to have a conversation with it. In the same way, you don't expect the devil to tell the truth. He's unable to tell the truth. You cannot make him tell the truth. You would be abusing him if you tried to make him tell the truth. He can't. And that's what you need to know. This is very important, especially for people who are in the deliverance ministry. You know, there are people who they are interviewing an evil spirit, they are trying to cast out an evil spirit. And I heard of a story from my friend Gomera of somewhere where they are casting out an evil spirit. And they asked, who sent you? And the evil spirit said, Abusa. And you know, it brought issues within the church. Hey, can you imagine? And then there are some people who are casting out an evil spirit, and they say, and maybe the evil spirit starts praising them. Oh, the fire in this place! The fire in this place! You are the biggest in Zambia! In Zambia, the one we fear! In Nigeria, it's... maybe they mention a man of God. Then they take the mic. You've heard what the evil spirit is saying? You know, no, that's a lying spirit. The thing can mislead you. When you're in the deliverance spirit, you must understand this truth. You have to be led by the spirit. There's what we call the gift of discerning of spirits. You have to be led by the spirit because these people, they are lying spirits. They are incapable of telling the truth. So you must always be led by the spirit. Praise God. I hope you're learning something. For he's a liar and he is the father of it. That's a step further. Meaning, he does not only tell a lie. There was no such thing as a lie until Satan created it in his own laboratory. He concocted it. It was something strange. It was shocking. Even God was shocked by it, in my own view. Because it's the first time something was created. That's what the word father means. It means originator. It means you are the first. You are the father of it. So even God was amazed. What's this thing? This is something to my will. We've not seen anything like it. So he became Satan. He was Lucifer. He became Satan, and God goes with him. See? And then he says, but because I tell the truth, you do not believe me. Which of you convicts me of sin? And if I tell the truth, why do you not believe me? He who is of God hears God's word. Therefore, you do not hear because you are not of God. So truth is a language based on God's word. And if you are from God, you'll be able to understand. This is why sometimes Some of your uncles, they will come, they will find you watching Sir Daniel. Ah, this young man just up here for money. They don't understand your language, your kind of life. They are probably not from God. Somebody says, no, I'm being mean. Then John chapter 1 verse 2 is actually being more mean than me, because it's the Bible. It says, but for as many as believed in him, to them he gave the right to become children of God. Pause right there. Before that, whose children were they? I'll leave that to your answer, because it's the Bible which says it. Glory to God. That's the truth. That's just the truth. See? Jesus had an issue communicating with the Pharisees because they didn't understand his language. Now, here is the reason why. Apart from, of course, the Baptists, they were from the devil was their mentor. The thing is, they were natural men, and we are getting somewhere as we are discussing the fruit of the Spirit. They were natural men. They were natural men. There are three types of men. I'm speaking this in relation to the faith, or maybe I'll say four, but let me say three. There's what we call the natural man, okay? Then there's what we call the baby believer, then there's what we call the carnal Christian, and then there's the spiritual man, okay? So number one, there is the natural man, and then number two, there is the baby believer, and then number three, there's the carnal Christian, and then number four, there is the spiritual man. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's dive right into this thing. Now, let's go to the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 2. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter number 2. Oh, Shalabaya man, Chabaya God. I'm enjoying this thing. I don't know about you. Glory to God. I command you to load fast. Can you command my Bible with me? This is Bibles of nowadays. Ewa mushilo Yesu. 1 Corinthians chapter number 2, and I'm going to read from verse, maybe let me begin from verse 10. It says, let me begin from verse 9. It says, but as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear has heard, nor has entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. But God has revealed them to us through his Spirit. Hallelujah. Isn't that beautiful? For the Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? The spirit man within you knows all things about you. That's what we are being told here. Then we are told, in the same way, no one knows what is in the heart of God except the spirit of God within him. So the totality of God has got stuff in him. But nobody knows what is in the totality of the person of God except the Spirit of God. But then we are being taught, we have been made to understand, or we've been exposed to the knowledge of the things which are in the person of God by the Spirit which is in him. Isn't that beautiful? These things are supposed to be a secret. The Old Testament folk never had this kind of privilege. But we are told there are some secrets in the person of God. We're talking about Father and Spirit. But then we have received the Spirit of God, who is able to reveal those things to us. Oh, glory to God. This is exciting. Hallelujah. I'm not going to digress. I'm going straight into the hallelujah. Now, we are told, now we have received not the spirit of this world, but the Spirit who is from God. Wow, 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 wow. That we may know the things that have been freely given to us by God. Then he says, these things we also speak, not in words which man's wisdom teaches, but with which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual things. And then we hit the point. He says, but the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. Oh boy, oh boy. He says, but the natural man cannot, he does not, because he cannot receive the things of the Spirit of God. So you can imagine there are all these good things that are in the heart of God, which we cannot access except we've got a relationship with the Spirit, who is the Spirit of God, who can give these things to us. Says we can have access to all these things by the Spirit of God. Now imagine all these good things we can have access to, but we are told a man who is natural is incapable of receiving the things of the Spirit. Why? Because his spirit has not been activated. How is your spirit activated? You've got to be born again. Remember, we quoted the book of Ezekiel 36:26, and I'll give you a new heart, and I'll give you a new spirit. Meaning, he will take away the stony one. That's what the Bible says. He will take away a heart. He will take away the old self, and he will put something new, something which is bendable, something that can bend to the will of God, something which has got the makeup to receive spiritual things, something which has got a spiritual antenna, something that can receive from the Spirit of God. So a person who is not born again does not have a new nature. A person who is not born again, who's not given his heart to Christ, whose heart has not been transformed yet, is incapable of receiving spiritual things. That's just sad. That's just sad. He does not understand the will of God. And so there are certain things a non-spiritual person cannot do. For example, the very next verse tells us, it tells us, but he who is spiritual judges all things. Now, this is obviously a scripture that just changed tables, because everybody's saying, do not judge as an excuse for doing everything wrong except what is right. See, they do not judge. Why? Because Jesus Christ says, he who judges shall also be judged. You know, but why did Jesus Christ, particularly in the book of Matthew, tell them, you cannot judge? Because they are not spiritual people. The Pharisees, the Sadducees, the teachers of the law did not have the capacity to judge. Why? Because they did not have the Spirit of God within them to inspire them to make judgment. They were natural men and incapable of making judgment. If we tell you what you're doing is wrong, stop it. We are filled with the Spirit, we are filled with the Word of God, we are very well. And then your people who like saying, do not judge me. No, I don't like men of God because they like judging. Okay, let's leave you to God. And let me just give you like a scripture on top. The Bible says, and how terrible it is to fall into the hands of the Almighty. You know, there are certain things, because we've got the Spirit of God within us, we are able to judge. We are able to help you. We are able to tell you that was wrong. When you face me like that, with me, you can even argue, no, but I was hungry, that's why I stopped. No ABC, because there was no one in the room, and all that kind of stuff. With me, you can even argue, with God, feeling of that chance. So if I am able to judge you, guess what? You don't have to go through the same thing with God. That's an advantage. That's what we call delegated authority. That's why a pastor is important in your life. The Bible says he watches over your soul, Hebrews 13:17, as somebody who's going to give account to God. It says, do not make his word, because he watches over your soul. Because that's big. God brings a person to watch over your soul. That's only God's job. Only God is able to watch over your soul. But guess what? He decides, I'm going to make a man to watch over your soul. You who think you are safe not having a pastor, you are not. Because you are directly responsible to God. You think that's good? Okay, go on with it. To have a man who's able to speak over you, who's able to call you and tell you, what did I hear? Sit down. Then you explain yourself, you even argue a bit, and then you do things. Ah, you are safe. So, a spiritual man is able to judge all things. Hallelujah. Because he's got the Spirit of God within him. But a non-spiritual man, a natural man, is unable to understand spiritual things. If I was to stand before 50 professors and I began, Encho, Barigdes, Giandos, Shadada, Glory, Sharombos, Ogiada, they'll say, can we get paramedics? This is a Chinama case. They don't understand spiritual things. See, this is why you've got to be careful who you marry. Amen, ladies? One night, you know, you wake up under the inspiration of the Spirit and go, Ocho Kachakaya, Lekupara Kachakaya, you know. I've seen some of these ladies, don't be, you see past their makeup. I've seen them pray. They pray like Hannah, like they are drunk. Even, as in Hannah prayed like she was so drunk that not a passerby, a prophet, man. A prophet said, are you drunk? Prophet! So, I'm telling you, you got to be careful. You know, one day you wake up under the inspiration. And there's some strange things sometimes you do under the inspiration of the Spirit. Like you just begin, you know, because the burden is so strong. The Bible talks about deep sighs and groanings which cannot be uttered. These groanings or these prayers are too deep for words. Words are too small to express them. When the Spirit of God comes over you like that and you just go, come guys, I woke up. Are you the same one I married? Less. So you've got to be careful. You know? Hallelujah. Because the natural man does not understand spiritual things. You think you're going crazy. You've got to be careful. So that's the natural man. He does not understand godly language. Even the Bible, when we explain it, just sounds some religious stuff to him. He cannot have a relationship with God. And then there is now the baby Christian. Now, I will not talk about the baby Christian. I'm going to talk about, please, when it's exactly 40 minutes, let me know so that I cut off. How many more minutes do I have? I'll have to go back and finish church. You can estimate for me. It's been 40 minutes. I've got 14 more minutes. Glory to God. I've got 14 more minutes to run. Okay. So, then there is the carnal man. Now, I'm telling you this because I'm preparing you for a teaching on the works of the flesh. Before we get into the fruits of the Spirit, we are going to dive deep into the works of the flesh. And we're going to talk about witchcraft, we're going to talk about all that kind of stuff. But first, you must understand the natural man. When you understand the natural man, it will be easy for you to understand the works of the flesh and all that. Without the gift of righteousness. He has not yet received the gift of righteousness. He's natural. He's a natural tree. Like, natural. Most spiritual life, the spiritual life is there, but it's so natural. It's natural. I don't know if that makes sense. It's natural. It's all about, waking up in the morning. It's all about working hard. It's all about living in life, growing up, passing school, you know, getting married, raising children, and dying. It's that boring. You know, it's just natural. There's nothing about God. And Satan can just come in and kick him and do everything he wants. In fact, he doesn't even bother Satan. There are people who say, the moment I got born again, that's when the attack started. Yes, you left Satan. Some of you were generous, you know, when you're in the world. Satan held a meeting. It was like a moment of silence. Said we, guys, we lost the general. We gotta do something about it, you know. So he's not gonna just let you go without a fight. But before that, I think he had nothing to do with you because you belong to him, you know. So you've got to understand that kind of stuff. And so this man has got no fruit of the Spirit in him. What he has are the works of nature, the works of the fallen nature. The works of the flesh. And to him, the works of the flesh are natural. It's natural to him. It's not strange to him. It's nothing that's, you know, out of this world to do some of the things he does. The Bible describes to us what these works of the flesh are. The natural man does these works of the flesh. We'll find them in the book of Galatians, chapter number 5. Adultery, witchcraft, fornication, reveling, wild parties, and oh yeah, we're gonna talk about that. And there are quite a number. I've never heard about the number of the works of the flesh, but we know the fruit of the Spirit is 9, you know. So there are quite a number. And somebody may say, everybody who's not born again is they're capable of doing witchcraft. Say, oh, they're capable of doing. Say, no, but I've never done that. You're just wait, just because mango tie. It's just, you are just waiting for the season. You are capable of doing it any time. There's no guarantee. As long as an opportunity, it's within you. You can exercise any of the works of the flesh anytime when the opportunity presents itself. You can do like a witchcraft. When the opportunity presents itself, you can steal. When the opportunity presents itself, fornication here. You know? And you will not even be bothered about it. Why? Because you are a natural man. It's your nature. Your nature has not been activated. The old nature has not been taken away. The Bible says, if any man is in Christ, he's a new creation. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And then the Amplified says, the spiritual and moral condition has changed. The old spirit has been taken away. There's a new spirit within you. Praise God. What a beautiful day. That's why the Bible says when that happens, the angels throw a party. That's what the Message Bible translation says. It's a strange miracle. Glory to God. So that's the natural man. Say, oh, but there are natural people who do nice things. Oh, well, there are natural people, sinful people doing nice things. No, but there are some natural people who they're not necessarily born again, but they're kind. They're kind sinners. No, there's some, you know, that they even give, they donate large sums. No, they're donating sinners. So, it doesn't change your sin. I mean, if you are John Chimpwembe, even if you give, it doesn't change your name. Even if you don't give, it doesn't change your name. See, that's a doctrine of righteousness. It's something else on its own. It's something you've got to understand. So that's a natural man right there. But then we've got the carnal Christian. This is my point of interest. The carnal Christian is, the word carnal means fleshly. It comes from a Greek word which means fleshly. Let's go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter number 3. Glory to God. I'm going to read from verse 1. He says, and I, brethren, could not speak to you as spiritual people, but as to carnal, like babies in Christ. Not babies, but like. Babies in Christ, it's like this. When you're born again, the sinful nature has been dealt with, okay? It's been taken away. That's what Jesus came to do. But you still have your mind to deal with. You've got your friends. So sometimes you find yourself going back to the past. Not that there's anything honorable in doing that, oh, because I'm a child. No. At least we know that when children are doing the wrong things, they don't mean to do them. Or even if they do them, they don't feel they are doing them. They just feel they're doing the right thing. I mean, a child... When a child is pressed, just they are perverse, they'll release themselves. You know, why? Because they're a child, and they'll think there's nothing wrong with it. They'll actually feel nice and laugh because they've been relieved. You know, but it's different. It's not something they do willingly. It says, but like babies, not meaning they've been in the faith for a while, but somehow they just never change. Same thing over and over again. Paul calls them ever learning but never coming to the knowledge of the faith, but ever learning. Leon said, ever learning, but never just getting it. You know that guy who's always in grade 7 or grade 9 or something, you know. It's a sad story, but you know, yeah, those people who you found them in first year, they're still doing like a course. Second year, they're doing like a course, they go on break, no, they didn't have school fees. Third year, they came back doing the same course. Not that it's a good thing, but you know, there's always that guy. You know, how come they're just never getting the course? See? So they're like that. It's not that they are young, or maybe it was just a mistake they made. No, they've been around for a while, but they are still able to behave like a worldly person, like a person who's a natural man. They can actually sit down with a natural man and understand each other's language. They are not comfortable when the guy is insulting. There's nothing wrong when they're in a bus and all these manner of strange songs are playing. I mean, I had to buy a headset. Because when you're on a bus, people listen to all kinds of strange stuff. I wouldn't even want to talk about something that I heard. But people are singing it as songs. And people are just there sitting very comfortably. It's not itching anyone that they're listening to that song. And you're right there comfortable. Buy a headset. Some things are not for your ear consumption. Glory to God. Oh yeah. And remember, listen, follow my writings titled Don't Sing Alone. Very important. Music has got this special capacity. I've got 5 more minutes. Music has got this special capacity to linger in your mind. It's strong. You may not have even wanted the song. Then on bathroom, now in Bama check a Jack and Michael Jackson singing. Why am I singing this song? I bind. Or a beat is playing by neighbors. It's not a good beat. Just find yourself. You know. You have to buy a headset. And I'm teaching this as a spiritual thing. And listen to good music. Why? I'll tell you. Because if you don't replace yourself with good music, bad music will replace the good music. And it will play consistently in your mind. It lingers in your mind. Just find yourself. No. At least if you're listening to a good song, it will help you. You know. All these simple things help you grow. Otherwise, you remain a carnal Christian. You've got to make sure. Peter says, but add to your faith kindness, and to your kindness goodness. That means it's not God's responsibility to help you grow in the fruit of the Spirit. It's your responsibility. If you are not deliberate about being kind, there will not be this like supernatural chill which will come on you. If in the world, if you are not a kind and patience, the path. If you do not learn to sit yourself down and say, okay, let me be patient, there will not be this supernatural window of patience that will come up to help you. No. You've got to learn to discipline yourself. When you are born again, God gives you the ability to grow the fruit of the Spirit. Later on, we will learn that it is not the fruit of the Holy Spirit. It is not the Holy Spirit who grows the fruit. The Holy Spirit comes to live in you, and He gives you the capacity to grow the fruit of the human spirit. The recreated human spirit must grow fruit. Jesus Christ in the book of John 5 says, He is the vine and we are the branches. So when we remain in the vine, we'll be able to bear fruit. It is not the trunk. It is not the vine which bears fruit. It is the branch. Then He says, if the branch does not bear fruit, I'll cut it off. So it is not, it didn't say, if the branch is not bearing fruit, I'll cut the whole tree. No. So your duty is to stay in the branch, in the vine, to stay in the trunk, in the main tree. And then it is also your duty to grow your fruit. This is why you've got to, sometimes if you know, okay, the patience, can I show up? You wake up in the morning and say, I'm patient. I've got the fruit of patience working in me. See? The problem we have is some version capitalizes the word S, the fruit of the Spirit. So we think it's the fruit of the Holy Spirit. The problem is we've got one word for the word Spirit in the Greek. One word. The same word is used for Holy Spirit and human spirit and spirit. But it is talking about the human spirit. It's like when you receive the gift of tongues. It is not the Holy Spirit gives you utterance, and then by His power, your spirit receives ability to speak. Then you begin to speak. The Bible says they spoke. It doesn't say the Holy Spirit spoke in them other tongues. That's a different dimension of prayer, which very few people even do. The realm of groanings. But even then, the Holy Spirit prays in you when He comes over you. See? So you've got to understand that it is your responsibility. Otherwise, God is not going to judge anybody if it is His responsibility. Why is judgment there? Because we would say, oh, God, you didn't grow my spirit. Whilst the Daniel's spirit is a joyful man. Me, you didn't come and visit me at night. No. It's your responsibility. That's why you must study the Bible. Get your Bible and start studying. Read. Patience, kindness. Oh, what is kindness? Read about it. Let your capacity begin to enlarge. Otherwise, you remain a carnal person. I'm going to read the last scripture. And I'm going to close. Ephesians chapter number 2. I'm going to read from verse 17. I would love to use the NLT version. Glory to God. We are on the carnal man. The carnal man behaves no different. You've been born again 2 years. You are still comfortable having the same old friends. Benarere. People are strange nicknames out there. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. I'm about to close. I think my time's up. No, you can't. You can't maintain the same phrase. There should be something wrong with you. If you can still sit down after 2 years struggling with the same music. You've been born again 2 years, you've got difficulties going to church. I don't like the way they look at me. You, well, how do you look at them? If you don't like the way they look at you, you are the one who first looked at them wrongly. And you, same one, you should repent. 2 years, born again, you can't give offering. You are kind of idea. I hope I'm saying it a lot. Hallelujah! Glory to God. Ephesians chapter number 4. Sorry. I'm gonna read from verse 17. It says, "With the Lord's authority I say this, live no longer as the Gentiles do." He tells them, don't live like worldly people, meaning you are very capable of living like a worldly person. Like a person who's not been transformed, like a person who's not received the Lord Jesus, like a person who's not received the gift of the Holy Ghost. It says, for they are hopelessly confused. Oh boy. Their minds are full of darkness. They wander far from the life that God gives because they have closed their minds and hardened their hearts against Him. You know, there are people, Abba for friend, I know. Jesus Christ is not an angel. You get scriptures, you read to them, they are convinced, okay, I've heard, but still more. What do you mean? Still more. Don't harden your heart. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 4, when you hear the gospel, do not harden your heart. Be easily persuadable by the word of God. God said, I wouldn't lead them by the way of the Philistines, although that was near, because they couldn't trust in me. In other words, God says they were not persuadable. These guys were they were stiff-necked. They could argue with God. Oh, you're bringing us his manna. You don't have other things on your menu. You can imagine. As if these guys were deaf. Don't be like that. They have no sense of shame. I don't know, but somebody said, Inson, you won't do. At this point, you would want to agree. What a coincidence. They live for lustful pleasures and eagerly practice every kind of impurity. They're eager. You know, there are people who, they behave like they're just on like a time bomb. They walk in town, the red wire for the time bomb is outside, waiting for you to just hook it. Then you have a test of their internal selves. They just, even that's the way they look at you, just, it's just going to blow anytime soon. They're just ready to say anything. Look at this. He says they eagerly practice every kind of impurity. Meaning they don't have an issue having bad language. They don't have an issue sitting down to watch porn. They don't have an issue talking about a person who's way older than them in a very sarcastic way. You know, they don't have an issue practicing any work of the flesh. They wouldn't have an issue being led to go or something. But he says, you shouldn't live like that. You've graduated. Type, I've graduated. And then he says, but that isn't what you learned about Christ. That isn't what you learned about Christ. Since you have heard about Jesus and have learned the truth that comes from him, throw off your old sinful nature and your former way of life. God is not saying he's going to do it for you. And I'm going to end here. Throw off your old sinful nature and your former way of life, which is corrupted by lust and deception. Instead, Let the Spirit lead you. Let me how to lead you. How the Spirit, for example, because the Holy Spirit is leading you. He says, put away your old self. God is not going to do it for you. God already did it for you by making you born again. No, you yourself have got to align. Sit down in church, learn the word of God, ask questions, grow. Do not be hard-hearted. Be willing to learn, change your ways. If you are told you can't dress like that anymore, why are you going to be doing, you've been told it's not decent, it's not right. You cannot talk like that to an elderly person. You cannot sit someone down who's older than you and start talking to them. You have to understand, you have to change your way of life. Okay, this is how to make your prayer life effective. Even if you are an advocate against tongues, you've learned, they help you make progress. They make you pray like this and make your prayer life effective. Sit down and learn. Your ways must change. Do not harden your heart. Put off your old self, especially guys, pride. You can't sit down under mentorship and learn from someone. He wouldn't say too much views to me. No, you know, these things, it's just about the way you believe. It's not just about the way you believe. Know the truth and the truth shall set you free. Learn the truth. Don't sit in ignorance and be convinced that's the truth. You die in your sins. That's what Jesus Christ said to the Pharisees in John chapter 8. He says, because you don't want to listen to me and you don't want to believe in me, you will die in your sins. And all they wanted was to look like at least they've got a point. No, we've also been studying these things for a while and we'd remove their Old Testament and quote it to him. He's trying to turn them to life. And then, you know, no, sit down and learn. You're not too grown up not to learn. Hallelujah. Praise God. And that's how you're going to stop living a carnal life. Then he says, stop telling lies. Let us tell our neighbors the truth. For we are all parts of the same body. And don't sin by letting anger control you. See? It says, don't tell. It's actually embarrassing for us to sit people down who've been in the faith for a long time and stay. You can imagine. Do not tell lies. In church, we are preaching. It's wrong to tell lies. But that's a carnal Christian for you. A carnal Christian has been in the faith for a long time. But will tell you a lie. And then immediately, Sunday school pants ever name. Children, don't tell lies to your daddy. Never, never. Children, don't tell lies to your mommy. Same realms.